Hey guys, welcome to the OS World Cup finals. I'm Mr. Color, joined by Creators and Deppy. And today we are going to watch the last matches, Korea versus Taiwan for the huge finals. Now before we get into this match, I want to talk about two teams. Of course, they have a really huge history with the OS World Cup. When it comes to Korea, they've won the OS World Cup last year and the year before, so they're sitting on two victories. They're looking really nicely, but Taiwan, they originally won the first OS World Cup, and they're coming back as strong as ever. You've seen them during the quarterfinals, the semifinals, and in group stage, and round of 16. They were as scary as ever, most notably with Rocker and Snow White, but the rest of the roster was also equally scary. So right now on the finals, first off, I don't think anyone expected this to be Korea versus Taiwan. I think most people expected this to be Korea versus Japan, but Taiwan took out Japan in the quarterfinals, so that's what we get. And quite honestly, I don't see who's gonna win this. I don't know. Taiwan seems like they have the advantage due to their awesome performance on previous rounds, but they're against Korea here. So when you're against a team that has won, single-handedly won the two last OS World Cups, there's really no telling who's gonna win this. So it'll be interesting to see, of course, which team is going to be able to win this. This is best of 13, I think. It's best of 11, sorry. First team to 6 points wins. So we definitely have a bit of a match awaiting us here. And our first warm-up match is going to be selected by Taiwan, still winning on two other players.
This is kind of interesting though. I mean, Taiwan wasn't really as much into it as Korea was in the previous years, the previous couple of years. And even though they were dominating the first year, you haven't really thought about Taiwan as a favorite. But it's probably interesting though if they can take the win this year. It's going to be like 2-2 between the two countries, because these countries are the only one that actually won the cup in the first place.
This is true. And actually, if you look at Taiwan's roster, it's mainly fairly old players. You look at Guan, Rocker, and Snow White. They've been here for a while, so it's a wonder why they haven't won all the World Cups so far. Probably because the Korean team was so strong the previous years, and now it might not be as strong this year.
I think one of the reasons maybe is I think Japan was still really strong this year, but last year they were particularly strong. They had other players like Apricot as well.
Uh-huh. Well, first off, that Taiwan managed to get a win off Japan was amazing, but
and definitely, we've seen Taiwan playing at their very best this year. We have had some incredible performances from the team, and I think that they're really performing as well as they can. And like perhaps what we've seen from Japan or even Korea this far, we feel that there's more potential in the Korean team than what we've seen so far.
Definitely. Especially from these two teams.
Obviously, from we have some Korean players that have been doing really, really well thus far. Tengu makes perfect sense to see him in the final. He's been pretty amazing throughout the entire tournament this far.
Yeah, Tengu, Shizuru, they've both been really scary. Of course, Dongjin. I think Dongjin overall is probably the scariest Korean player, but their roster is so consistent, it's hard to tell.
Yeah, and really, when you look in the Korean players, I don't think you will find anyone around that has better aiming, like this crazy aiming ability on the Korean side. And that might make a huge difference, we'll see.
Oh, wow. Okay, we're getting a taste of this World Cup 1 with the first warm-up match being Emerald Sword. Now, this is an old map, ladies and gentlemen. That's 2009 style right there. But yeah, if for old farts like me who've been around since the beginning of the OS World Cup, this map was actually in the finals for the first OS World Cup won by Taiwan. So I guess it's a bit of a callback to that. Pretty nicely picked by Taiwan there.
I think Uwen was practicing the Emerald Sword quite a lot to get his full combo on that. to get a full combo on Emerald Sword is pretty amazing, because it's just so different from beatmaps of today, and you have to focus on aspects you really don't need otherwise. The patterns are hard to read, the approach rate is low, it's very outdated in terms of what you can, if you compare it to modern us, obviously.
And of course, the infamous circle size.
Oh yeah, obviously. And it's fast. It's fast. It just doesn't feel like it's fast. And those kind of beatmaps are difficult, especially if you're used to the kind of beatmap you see today. I expect to see a lot of misses on this.
Oh yeah. God bless Raikin. He was an amazing mapper. You can see actually a bit of an early miss from Snow White for Taiwan, so right off the bat, there's quite a few misses from him. Korea has an early advantage here.
Strange warm-up map. Honestly, when I feel I play these kind of beatmaps, I do really poorly on anything else.
Yeah.
It's kind of like I have to reset my mind, get into the 2009 mode.
But we've seen very weird warm-up maps throughout this whole tournament, but this is a first. I think it's just the callback to World Cup number one.
This is the Taiwan pick, right?
Yes.
Well, then it makes perfect sense.
And you can see Taiwan actually having a pretty strong advantage here. Our Rocker and Uan haven't broken combo yet.
Yeah. Kind of makes sense. I mean, both Rocker and Uden was around at this time, and they're kind of, it's like a matter of generation. Like, players that play during this time will do particularly well in these kind of beatmaps.
I remember a huge rivalry between a Rocker and Kuthisi on this map to get number one.
Oh, back in the day when those were the two, always fighting for number one.
And now Taiwan has a really strong advantage over Korea. Look at these score difference. It's almost 10 million points of difference.
Gotta love the sliders. Squared sliders. You really have to follow them properly as well, because the slider wheel is pretty small, so basically when you move, you have to follow the squarey movement as well. You just almost have to consider it as a square. It's really fun patterns to play, actually.
Good old school maps. They're always a blast to play. Yeah, as we speak, Taiwan once again increasing the lead. Uan has not missed yet.
And they're getting a little bit of a psychological advantage here.
Oh yeah. Well, I guess they practiced a lot for this beatmap, and I mean, players like Huan and Rucker, even though they missed here, they definitely used to playing it. Dongjin's doing pretty well for Korea, though, he can keep that up.
Yeah, it's pretty much like you said, Dongjin being the best player overall.
If not the best, maybe the most consistent.
Yeah, consistent in terms of he's versatile, he can play lots of stuff. Like, you have players such as Chizuru, who is a 2012 player, and you can see that on some of the results, like here, for instance, that he's really struggling to play all beatmaps. And it's really typical for modern players to struggle with all beatmaps. I don't know how important it really is to play all beatmaps today, but it still is something to consider, that there's a kind of skill that is sort of lost.
It's true. What I like also about this map and this map set overall is that it's a great song choice for our OS World Cup final. And this is going to go towards Taiwan here. Pretty one-sided, actually. You see 10 million points of difference. No full combos, but a really strong play from Rocker and Uan getting upwards of 700 combo. Dongjin for Korea did pretty well also, but that's going to go towards Taiwan's first warm-up. Let's see if we keep seeing more unexpected warm-ups from Korea, or if we're gonna see more standard ones.
Well, Korea better pick something they're good at right now. Just something that can get some kind of psychological advantage and take it back. Something really fast, perhaps, or really jumpy, aimy. Anything I can think of Korea being really good at.
Anything that is not... Oh, okay, never mind. The big black. Alright, this is more recent. We've seen that one before, I think. Now the question is, will it be like before and will they play with double time?
I don't think we're gonna see mods. I certainly hope you don't.
Oh man, yeah, who doesn't know the big black by now? It's very, very, very popular. Blue Dragon, the quick round fox match.
Well, I know some people are gonna shoot me for this, but actually there's a lot of work put into this beatmap. It's just people hate it because it's so popular, but it's a good piece of work. It is. I'm not saying it's a great beatmap, but it's still a lot of work to make those patterns.
It's an interesting take on hard beatmaps, definitely.
But yeah, it's a symmetrical map as well, and that's why it's so weird.
Yeah.
And for a symmetrical beatmap to be that hard is kind of contradictory. Like, I wouldn't expect someone who maps in that kind of fashion to make such a hard beatmap. It's really
weird. This is true. So what's interesting is no team picked Big Money for practice or warm-up.
I don't think Big Money is around anymore. I think it was
It's not, but I'm pretty sure some people still have it. I still have it, for what it's worth.
I have never even played it. I haven't even seen it.
I refuse. It, it's as bad as people say it is.
Yeah, that's why I didn't check, actually.
You can see already right off the bat, Chizuru is doing much, much better than earlier. And Taiwan's having a bit of struggle with this. But every player is broken so far, so there's really no telling.
I can only think of like two players that can play this consistently well, and that's gotta be Ryuichi or Cookies himself. Like,
yeah.
We don't have a lot of players playing this really well. I don't think Kroos can even do this pretty well, like straight off the bat in a multiplayer match.
Chizuru's doing pretty well for Korea, but I think the damage still is towards Taiwan. No, Korea actually taking the lead right now. Mainly thanks to Chizuru's score.
I was about to say I don't think Chizuru's gonna miss now, but he did, so... Well, never mind. This is way too fast, way too confusing, really.
Yeah.
I gotta say, it's really even at the moment. You can probably tell
it's
gonna win.
There's under a 10,000 point difference, so it's really, really close, actually. Despite Chizuru's really, really good score, I mean, Taiwan's hanging on. You can look at Snow White's score, it's actually pretty nice here.
But I gotta say it to you, like, Chizuru, who's probably pulling the win for Korea right now, is... That is some incredible accuracy.
Oh yeah, definitely. I think this is gonna be a character Chizuru here. Korea's finally digging up and score. Snow White doesn't seem like he'll be able to come back at this.
As I expected, I did expect to see someone fail. I wonder if they did.
Oh, but this is still going to Korea because Tengu for Korea fails, so does so do Rucker and Snow White for Taiwan. So pretty much their biggest score collapse right there. And this is gonna be a win for Korea with Chizuru doing a really, really nice work on this with 6 million points and 97 accuracy.
I'm pretty sure he's gonna full combo this someday.
He might. I mean, he's not that far off. Only three misses. Yeah, this is one warm up for Korea, one warm up for Taiwan. So we're gonna move on to the actual maps now. Let's see how let's what we get, and let's see how players will do on it. Our first map is going to be selected by Taiwan, so let's see how that goes. And before we get into this, which Nomad pick do you think is the scariest this round? For me, it's between Yakujin Summon of Couple Dance, Shuffle Heaven, and Kamui.
Really, personally, I think that the scariest one just has to be Kamui.
Yeah.
it's just crazy. Like, I'm not really much of a fast streamer, and it scares me to play it. To be honest, like, that's really the only beatmap of those that really scares me out. Obviously, Shuffle Heaven is also really hard.
Yeah. Shuffle Heaven is actually really, really recently ranked map. I actually made the another for this, and I remember the first time I saw Maddie's extra, I was like, what the hell is this, Maddie? But yeah, it's a really solid map in its own way. It's not the first time we've seen Maddie's insane slash another beatmaps in the OS World Cup, so...
What is interesting though is to see the Yakujin no Couple Dance really just out of, it's 2010, 2011 or something. It's really, it feels old because it's created to be kind of old style at the time it was created. So it's this portrait age, it's really fast streams, kind of where it's facing. I'm pretty sure that maybe Taiwan would be better than Korea at this one. I wouldn't be surprised if Taiwan would pick it.
Well, when it comes to that, actually, about old speed maps, like you were saying, on the Hard Rock mix, we have Anisaki Somatic Mutation Type Forza. That's 2010 right there.
Oh, yeah. Definitely. I mean, this beat map was crazy hard back in 2010.
It is a really, really old map.
And the circles are so small. I think it's really
they
funny
are
that we finally get to see.
Smaller.
Exactly. We get to see this kind of aspect, the old Skarmate, like the before name changed, the really old style beatmaps. I love these.
Alright, and our first beatmap is going to be Ningen Shikaku. That's a Nomad pick, actually. So what do you think about this beatmap, Careers?
Let's see. Shikaku, oh yeah, the Nomad beatmap.
Yes.
Right, it's pretty intense. Like, when I was playing it, I was not happy about being a mouse player, that's for sure. It's pretty, like, constantly jumps all over the place. One thing I just thought when I was playing it myself was just mouse drift, because my mouse was just going crazy. I'm pretty sure the Talos player is not going to have much of a problem, though.
I think we could see some cool combos here.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we're going to see at least one.
And you can see actually Rocker swapping out for I Will Be Back for Taiwan. Pretty interesting.
Well, maybe it just doesn't feel like playing it, or I Will Be Back is particularly good.
Snow White does have number 2 on this, on the rankings with a hidden play, and actually I Will Be Back makes sense because he has the number 8 on this.
Or maybe it's Rocker pulling a practical joke on us and he will be back.
That's pretty good. However, for Korea, they also have pretty good scores on this. Dungeons number 5 with Hard Rock, Dragon Humans number 11 with Nomad, Shizu number 13 with Nomad also. So there's a bunch of Taiwanese and Korean players on this top 50, so it'll be interesting to see how they can do. They all had full combos too, so definitely
makes
should
sense.
Do it.
I would definitely practice this a lot, considering the chances it will actually appear as well. I'm pretty sure also though that every single of these players are using a tablet. They are, aren't they?
Yeah, Shizuru used to be playing mouse only, but I think he switched to tablet, didn't he?
Yes, well, he's a sort of an AIM prodigy, I would call him. Someone who is good at AIM, regardless of what kind of peripheral he decides to use. He was crazy at aiming at Miles as well. He was probably the best aimer, Miles using aimer ever, and he was Miles only as well, which is kind of crazy. As soon as he goes, switches to tablet, you stop seeing him for a while, but he's really come back to recent months. He's showing his full potential, I suppose.
Didn't he do that crazy score on a remote control the other day?
Yes, he did, and actually I didn't know anyone but Ryuichi could do that.
Ryuichi actually saw that score and was like, no, I want that, and he got it right back. That was actually really, really funny.
Yeah, like someone asked me, like, yeah, he's back. I was like, well, he didn't exactly leave, so... this is the problem, really. I'm kind of sad because like, we need players like Shizuru to become really good. Because Ryuichi needs someone to be really good for him to bother doing anything. Like, the competition is so vital to the progression of Ryuichi because he needs something to strive for. And as soon as, like, you see in the later times, he hasn't been playing as much, hasn't been doing the same kind of things, he doesn't really care too much about the rankings, he plays perhaps a hard rock without hidden or something like that. Like, I really feel he needs more competition, someone that can beat him.
Well, we'll see about that. For now, looks like we have a player switch for Korea. Yeah, Cheese is going to replace Fury for this. And both teams have swapped players, so we should be starting anytime soon here for our first map of these finals.
Oh yeah, Cheese is definitely another of these Korean players that are just so ridiculously good.
Mm-hmm. Alright, and here we go with our first map, Ningen Shikaku. A bit of an early break from a dungeon for Korea. No, actually, never mind. But Taiwan does have a bit of an early advantage, it seems, but it's really, really close. I think I will be back. I actually missed, which is going to give Korea... Korea's going to take the lead here.
To think about it, like, how much does a miss actually mean at this part of the tournament? Is it so breaking that if one of the players misses, the team automatically loses because the other team will surely keep the full combo?
Actually, look at Dongjin and Cheese, they both broke, so actually it's Taiwan taking the lead here, despite Uen missing, and I will be back to early miss. Smolka and Snow White still holding strong, so it's gonna be between Smolka and Snow White and Shizuru and Tengu for Korea. But now Taiwan with a 2 million points of advantage, now Korea have to wait for Taiwan to miss if they want to come back.
I'm pretty sure at the moment they seem to be coming back. We have two full combos fighting each other, and the other combos are... I would say Korea is doing a little bit better than Taiwan at the moment, even though the score is in favor of Taiwan. It's because of one of the misses.
Look at the score difference, it's not even a million points. As expected of this match, this is really, really close, but it seems like Taiwan's pulling ahead quite a bit now. I think we've got a pretty bad combo break from Cheese, but oh my god, they're coming back now! Because Small K missed for Taiwan, so now Korea's actually going to be able to take the lead from Taiwan, but this is all really, really close. We are halfway through the map, so anything could still happen here, but Korea being able to take a bit of a lead with Tengu and Shizuru doing really well here. I don't think they've missed yet.
I would hope to see Roku being able to pull this out together with Snow at the moment. You can see that the two full combos from the Korean side, as well as the building combo of Dungeon, is pretty much taking over the lead here.
This is probably why I didn't want to hype Taiwan too much, because due to the fact that Korea was so good for these last 2 years, and now they don't seem as good because they've conceded matches during group stage and knockout stage, people think they're not as good as they were. I tend to disagree with that. They're still really good. They made their way into the finals. They are definitely there. And they have, right now, a 13 million point difference with Taiwan.
Remember that as of a whole match between Korea and another country in the OEC tournament, the only time the Koreas ever lost was towards Taiwan in 2010.
And that's actually really interesting.
Only time the Koreas ever lost a match. Now, there's one thing losing on a map, but they're always winning in the end. So, as far as that's concerned, statistically, well, it's really hard to say. I mean, considering that Taiwan is the only team that has beaten Korea as well.
However, it looks like this first round is going to go towards Korea, because the score difference is now 12 million points, and despite Snow White's really good score with a full combo and Smolke coming back with a really good combo as well, Korea is holding strong with Shizuru's full combo and the Cheese's really good score right now. So this doesn't look like it's going to be Taiwan's first win. Actually, Taiwan picked this, so they give an early advantage to Korea here. And yes, this is going to be a win for Korea by 14 million points with a really, really strong play from Shizu. 53.3 million points on Taiwan's side. We do have Snow White doing really, really nicely too with 53.8 million points, actually getting the highest score of the map. But when it comes to the rest of the score, it's generally higher for Korea. Cheese and Dungeon getting 19, 18 million points, compared to Uwan and I will be back getting 12 and 14. And Tengu getting 28 compared to Smolke getting 25. So this is going to go towards Korea, this first map, and we will also select the next match. Next map.
It's no doubt. I think Snow White is probably the best player playing in this match altogether, or best of all the players included.
He did do the best. He has, look at his accuracy, it's actually really, really really impressive. Only 10 100s, 99.40%. But it's actually really, really weird. We've been used this entire tournament to Taiwan taking the early lead, and teams not quite able to come back. And here they are giving the first map to Korea, and Korea's going to be able to pick the next map. So they're going to try and put themselves at an advantage here, and they're going to select Shuffle Heaven.
Snow, now, Shuffle, you see this Heaven. Crazy madness from Maddie.
Yeah. This is another no mod pick. Probably, yeah, it's much, much, much shorter than the map we just played, but it's also really, really intense. There's a lot, towards the end, there's really, really fast slider stream jumps. And I'm really interested to see how players can do on these, because there's so many players that have broken on them.
When I saw this beatmap for the first time, I was kind of shocked, because the streams aren't just fast, you also change direction quite rapidly,
yes,
during midstream, and that's just really confusing. And it's like halfway overlapping and suddenly just changing the direction. It's gonna be really interesting to see how the players will do that.
I mean, right now the only scores with mods, or only full combos with mods, are by Wubwoofwolf with Hidden Hard Rock and Sapphire Ghost with Hidden. Everything else is a no mod. No mod score, and the top 40 isn't even full combos yet. So I don't expect to see that many full combos here, but we do have Rocker replacing Uwan for Taiwan though, and Dragon Human are replacing Cheese for Korea.
pretty much reckon both teams to be quite equally strong in this one, actually. Mm-hmm. They have, it's a wise pick to play. It's Dragon Human in, because he's a really fast streamer, and on modern beatmaps he's just crazy. So, smart players are up there. But otherwise, I do feel that Taiwan is probably one of the best teams when it comes to these kind of fast, streamy beatmaps.
You can see actually Taiwan has a bit of an early lead here with Snow White, I Will Be Back, and Rocker Cordy currently holding full combo. Smoke had an early miss, but he's also doing quite nicely. Curry's not far behind though, gotta watch out. The score difference is quite low right now, it could still go either way. We see a lot of misses around the board. Curry is actually gonna be able to come back here. Rocker now Will Be Back missed, so they're gonna be able to take a lead here. Tengu Shizuru is still holding strong, Dragon Human coming back, and so is Dungeon. You see, actually, Taiwan had a 3 million point lead, and now it completely converted to a 7 million point lead from Korea. They're now increasing the lead by quite a bit. Taiwan's looking really, really in dire straits right now. Look at the score, it's ever so slowly increasing.
Korean team is really like performing to their best at the moment. They're actually showing the kind of performances we kind of expected to see from them early in this tournament, but it just hasn't really shown. Who knows, maybe they've just been holding back. Maybe now it just got real and now they're just going to be at their best. And as we remember them from last year as well.
Look at the score difference. 30 million points of score difference. A huge domination from the Korean team on this, with Shizuru and Tengu getting 22 and 24 million points. Really, really impressive play, especially from Shizuru getting a combo break at the end. But only 4 100s in the entire map. No misses. Taiwan doesn't really have anything to contest that. Snow White is the best scorer in this team, and he's far behind with 15 million points. That's a complete domination by Korea, taking the second win on this match. A really, really, really strong play right there.
I think Taiwan really needs to host the Yakuin as soon as possible. I feel like they really have to focus. Like, Emerald Dragon showed us that they're better at all their beatmaps. They just have to find the kind of things, the kind of aspects, pick a kind of aspect where they can be stronger than Korea, basically.
Yeah, they have the they can select the map now, so they have the chance to come back at least 2-1. This will help them tremendously if they can do that.
For some reasons, a lot of people, not knowing that I'm Careers, well, I am.
Yes, and I'm Mr. Color commentating as always for the Videos World Cup. And next pick is still waiting. We're still waiting for Taiwan. I'm also just to see if we're gonna see any changes. Usually, last round it was Uwen, Smalke, Rocker, and Snow White. This time we have I Will Be Back instead of Uwen.
I guess I Will Be Back wasn't lying.
Just love those names. Actually, this is not at all how I would have expected this match. I actually expected Taiwan to dominate once again because, I mean, they've went 5-2 against Japan, so it just goes to show how strong they can be. But I never expect to see Korea actually lead by 2-0 right now. I actually predicted a win by Taiwan, I think by 6-3. And I don't think anyone has really expected Korea to come back at this point, so if they can pull it off, they'll effectively get their third win on Oslo Cup in a row, which would be really, really, really impressive from them.
Just something to consider though, it's like when you look at the Korean side and you think about, well okay, if they win today, they've been winning for the third year, consecutive year. However, most of the players in the Korean teams are not the same we've seen in the past years. And I'm pretty sure these players are hungry to win as much as they've been as always. So the only player I can see here that was in the previous tournament was probably Dungeon.
Yeah, and Kirikaru. But we've been used to other Korean players in this World Cup, like Binjip, or a Rising Judon game, or she's also participated last year, I remember. Crazy usually was the captain. So it's actually really, really interesting to see this new roster still managing to get into the finals and still having that lead against their opponents.
I was kind of speculating about Kersey's role last year, and I feel that kind of the way he was drilling his team was making Korea play at their best in the early stages of the tournament, which is pretty much the reason why they were so dominant. This year, I feel like they've been slacking a little bit, honestly. Like, we just see it the way we're just so surprised that they're finally playing like we expected them to in the first place, now in the finals. But before that, we've seen them dropping points against teams that are... Which shouldn't really happen considering the skill level difference.
The winning on the next pick for Taiwan, it's going to be really hard for them to select the right map because Korea is strong all around and they have players that specialize in different mods, so they have to take all that into account. So, actually, you haven't seen any mod picks so far. What mod do you think we'll see first? Is it going to be Hidden, Hard Rock, or Double Time? I've tend to notice that Hidden was actually not picked quite as much as in the previous years.
Maybe because this year it's not exactly new, and I don't think most of the players like Hidden as much. But Hidden is definitely something that's really useful in the early stages, but we've seen Hidden maps being pretty hard, and as for Hidden maps, I don't think most of the players would like to use them as much. I think when you look at these two teams, I don't think Hidden is an option, really. I think it's Double Time and Hard Rock. Hard Rock basically being what I think the Taiwanese side would prefer, and Double Time being what the Koreans would prefer.
Probably, yeah. And this time around, we have some really, really strong Double Time picks. I mean, you look at Perugia and Fermion, for example. And for Hard Rock, like we said, Anisakis, and actually, I wanted to take a look at Reunion on Hard Rock. It's actually a really interesting pick right there, because that's 180 and really, really strong accuracy demanded with death streams all around. So
It's arguably one of the most controversial picks of this pool.
Yeah.
And just to explain the reason why is because it's not actually that hard in terms of aim. It's one of those beatmaps where you only need stream speed and reading speed, basically. And you can also get by just getting an A. You can get 87% accuracy and get a full combo on this. Mm-hmm. So in terms of how much score you get from that is actually worth it, considering getting a random miss or something like that. So I don't feel like getting an accuracy war on Reunion, well, I just can't see it happening because I think most of the players just cheese through it.
It's true, yeah. And our next pick is going to be Force of Wind, another Nomad pick from Taiwan this time. This map is actually quite long. It's an extended version of a Force of Wind, but this is a really, really tough beat map. Lots of streams, very high speed overall. It's kind of a mixed bag. It has its fair share of jumps. Also has a really, really strong streams to master. I'm really interested to see how they will do on this.
Most of all, it's a beat map where you actually have to jump towards the streams going in these directions. That's what makes it really hard. And some of the streams are also overlapping the sliders, which also creates that barrier when you're trying to read it properly. Mm-hmm. So I think this beat map is definitely going to be hard. And some of the jumping parts as well, like the slider jumps mid part, is just ridiculous.
Yeah. If you look at the Korean team, actually, they have a few scores in the top 40 here. Cheese is number 3, Shizuru is number 6, Dragon Cuban is number 7, Dungeon's number 11, and Hakuriram is number 27, and for Taiwan we do have Snow White's number 5 and Rocker number 12, so they all have full combos because the top 40 is not full of FCs because, like I said, the map is so hard.
Well, just considering how it's hard and how it's really, really long, will we see more than one full combo? I'm pretty sure we're going to see at least three full combos in this one.
Shizuru's been doing really, really nicely, almost full comboed Shuffle Heaven, so if anything, I think he has a fair chance here. And I think we're going to see a player switch for Korea. Tengu is swapping out. Let's see who's going to come in. It's probably going to be Kirikaru in my opinion. Probably Kirikaru or could be a Dragon Human too.
Dragon Human is already in.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Could be Fury though. I haven't seen him that much yet.
I also think Hakurai Reimu is also playing at the moment. But it's Cheese, yeah.
Oh, it's gonna be Cheese, yeah. Well, he was playing earlier, so it makes sense that he is here. Are we gonna see any switches from the Taiwanese team? Doesn't look like it so far. They were selecting the map, so. Yeah, we're back with our usual team of four for us, or at least our usual setup for Taiwan, with Wu and Small K, Rocker and Snow White. This is the team that won against Japan. This is the team that won against Poland. So this is the team I want to see winning against Korea, but let's see how we do here, because Korea is another matter entirely.
I think it was, okay. I think it was last year that Japan actually managed to pull a few points back at the very end before Korea delivered the final blow. I wonder if you're seeing a reprise of that.
Yeah, this is true. The thing about Force to Win is that the beginning is actually pretty simple. So it actually gives you free score, or at least free combo to build up, and from that you can really start building scores. So any misses will be really, really penalizing for either of the teams.
I'm just gonna be interested to see who can get a full combo on this slider part. We're gonna see some slider part going across the entire bitmap, basically.
And the thing is, it's this part right there is actually kind of slow, but you can so easily miss on it, because usually players tend to underestimate when it's slow, but it actually trips up a few people I've seen during this tournament. We're coming towards the hard part here. Alright, so we'll look for any misses, and it looks like we've had some for the from the Taiwanese side, actually. Just slight lag. No worries here, all players still holding strong as we come to the hard part.
Yeah, then Cheese missed on the hard part.
I think Small K broke combo 2 for Taiwan. We have several misses here, as I said, Small K and as you said, Cheese, but also Uen for Taiwan. So Korea actually gonna be able to take the lead here. Snow White and Rocker is still holding really well for Taiwan, but it's two full combos against three at the moment. Chizuru, Dungeon, and Dragon Human doing really, really well for Korea right now.
This beatbox is much shorter than I remembered, actually. So considering how short it is at the moment, Korea's taking this in just a few more
there
seconds.
There is a death stream part incoming, though, that could change, potentially.
I don't think so. The stream part is actually the easy
missed.
Part.
The score difference isn't that strong. Taiwan could come back here.
They're actually coming back.
Taiwan's
as well.
Actually taking the lead here.
That's what happens when you have a full combo and you make.
Yep, there you go. I mean, this is exactly what I was saying from this death stream part. The map's not over yet, so everything could still go either way. But this is two full combos against one. Once again, Rocker and Snow White, the nightmare combo from Taiwan is really, really hurting Korea right now. Look at the score advantage. They are taking off. And this is going to be a win for Taiwan. Great comeback. Taiwan's going to be able to come back from 2-1 with 22.5 million points of difference, two full combos, Snow White getting 30 million points, and Rocker getting 29.8 million points. Definitely pull off this win. Really, really strong play by both of the players. From Korea, though, Dragon Human did really, really good with 23.2 million points, but that's far from enough to beat the two Taiwanese assassins that are Rocker and Snow White. Once again,
absolutely amazing that we get to see them
and come back 2-1.
Absolutely amazing that we get to see them working together and pulling this off. I think we all hope to see Snow White and Rocker playing as well. And this is really like the reason, as when they're playing together and they're playing really well, then maybe not even Korea can stop them. Who knows?
Actually, I think we've set some records here. Yep, Snow White actually set number 5 with that score. And I think Rocker also set a new record. Let's see. Yep, he set number... that was his old record, because Rocker only got 29.8, so that's an old record, but Snow White definitely setting a new record with the score. Ooh, and our next map selected by Korea is going to be our first double time fix. Flame and count one more encore. So, Koreans, you've talked about double time fix, how Korea is better with them, and how exactly are they better than Taiwan on double time?
Well, the thing is that actually both countries are really, really good at double time. It's just that Korea has more players that spend most of their time playing double time, such as Dragon Human. They can just bring in a lot of players that play a lot of double time. Hakuru Lame as well. Shizuru plays a lot of double time. Dungeon is well known to playing the hardest kinds of double time. So basically, I'm just saying that they're just a little bit better when it comes to double time. You just see them a lot. Yeah. And I think most of the players will consider themselves as being double time players, unlike others like Snowwood and Rocker being more versatile.
Yeah. Well, let's see how it goes. We have a player switch from Taiwan. Dabanong's replacing Uwen, and for Korea, Hakuri Reimu is replacing Cheese. Looks like Korea is going to be able to take a bit of an early lead here. You see a Rocker actually having an early combo break. It's actually Korea having a pretty nice lead right now. They're going to increase this all full combos from them. Actually, Hakuri Rainbow holding double S right now.
We've seen that Rocker is actually struggling with the speed of this beatmap, and you see the accuracy is really hurting because of that.
I mean, he's the only player that has broken so far. Actually, Davenlong's breaking now for Taiwan, so Korea's gonna be able to take off and score here. None of their players have broken yet. And Hakuri Reimu's still holding double S for Korea.
I guess this is what happens when you play against four Korean double time players.
It's true. The score difference is at 11 million points here. I don't see Taiwan coming back, quite honestly, unless all the players from Korea miss. This is probably gonna go towards Korea. Despite Smallkey and Snow White doing really, really nicely, especially if you look at Smallkey's accuracy, they are holding full combo, but that is not going to be enough. None of the players from Korea seems to be combo breaking, so this is definitely gonna go towards Korea now. Actually, it looks like we finally have breaks from the Korean players, but it's still not going to be enough. Let's see.
Two late misses.
Yeah, two late misses from our Korean room, which don't really matter. This is a win for Korea by 23.5 million points with three full combos by Dungeon, Shizuru, Dragon, Human, and almost a full combo by Hakuri Reimu with two misses at the end. almost double S. Really, really strong play. They all got 17 million points. Taiwan is far behind this time, with Rucker really struggling and Daven Long not quite getting a good score either. So Korea coming to increase the lead with 3-1 now, and next step will be selected by Taiwan.
Well, Taiwan can praise themselves happy that Korea can't really put into a lot more double time in this one.
Yep. This is true, and with Fremod, you have to take into account that Fremod, you can still put Hard Rock on it, but you can't put Double Time.
Exactly, and I do feel that Taiwan is a better team when it comes to the kind of Hard Rock beat maps we've seen so far. I wouldn't even be surprised if we see the famous Hard Rock beat map here. The and it's like his somatic mutation type Forza. That would be so epic if we got to see that.
That would once again be a callback to the first Dust World Cup, where this map was actually selected. Back in the day, there were no mods. It was all no mods, so of course, that was that, but still. It would be a nice callback. So do you think Taiwan's gonna go for a Hard Rock pick next, or are they gonna keep going with Nomad / Fremod?
Keep to Hard Rock, obviously, but Nomad or Hard Rock, those are the best options for Taiwan, I think. But another thing is, though, like, if they do choose a hidden map, they might actually, if they're good at hidden, obviously, that's gonna be an advantage. I did see Dragon Human play some of the hidden beat maps when he was practicing, and he was literally raging quite a bit over the how difficult it was, apparently, to play Approach Rate 9 hidden.
Well, all of these maps in the hidden bracket are really, really tough. Look at Smile Split and Meme. I mean, these are really tough beat maps. At least Meme is kind of short, but Smile Split goes on for a while. And it's really, really tricky. You have to remember pretty much everything on that map.
I think with the current setup, Taiwan should pick Reunion.
That's what
I would have done. I would pick Reunion.
Well, Snow White and Rocker could probably get a really good accuracy on this, but they have to hope that the two remaining players on their team don't miss at all. Because Korea, they can handle the snap, I think. Even if they don't get as good as Rocker or Snow White in terms of accuracy, I mean, I think there's a lot of players from Korea that could potentially full combo Reunion Hard Rock.
I think everyone here can pretty easily full combo Reunion, but the thing is just though, it's hard to get a timing right, and especially if you're not used to playing the kind of beat maps, you will struggle a lot. Another big map that I'm pretty much expecting Korea to fear being picked by Taiwan. Wow, not bad.
Well, Koreans, you're really good at this. Perhaps you give some insight to the Taiwanese team if they're listening to this, which I doubt they are. But Reunion is going to be our next pick. That's a Hard Rock pick, made by Orn HSHC. So this is a pretty streamy map, 180 BPM. With the Hard Rock and the death streams, it's pretty much going to be an accuracy battle, as we've said. It'll be interesting to see if any player's combo break, though.
Well, if Taiwan can be Korea in this one, the next beat map they should choose is definitely Jakujin.
It's true.
Let's see if I can be right twice in a row. That would be fun.
Yep. You got the pro player insight. I mean, I'm not good, so I can't really predict that kind of thing, but. And it looks like we have a few players' switches here. Uwen's gonna replace Daven Long. And it looks like we have another player swap from Korea. We see Dragon Human is leaving the match, probably gonna be replaced by Chizor Kirikaru here.
Well, makes sense to not see Dragon Human. He was the one who was raging so much about Reunion after all.
Yep. And yep, it's going to be Kirikaru coming in for Korea for this next match.
What I'm anxious to see is how Shizuru will do in this.
Yeah, he's been doing really good this entire match, actually. Being really, really scared to the Taiwanese team, so let's see how he can do with Hard Rock. When it comes to reunion, to the high scores, let's see. I don't think there's that many. Oh, see, yeah, there's Rocker with a hit at Hard Rock score. He's number 26, and Yuko Sama actually from Taiwan is number 29, also with hit at Hard Rock. But there's not that many Korean players. Dungeon is number 43, so he's quite far behind.
They're the only players that play this a lot and with great accuracy, or this is the most prominent accuracy player. See, I think actually Taiwan has a slight lead towards Korea based on accuracy alone.
But actually, he went to actually pretty tanking accuracy with 92% right now. But Rucker and Snow White, yeah, holding strong, especially Rucker with 99 accuracy right there.
Oh, yeah, I think Rucker was playing this a lot back in the day as well, and it was ranked while Rucker was the most active.
Yeah, it was 2011, 2012, wasn't it?
I think this was a 2011 beatmap.
Yeah, so it's quite old actually.
It might actually be late 2010, to be honest.
Ooh. Let me check that.
It's kind of like, it's a map of our.
It's early 2011, yeah.
Yeah, it's early 2011. I just remembered it was really like close to 2010.
Actually, Korea is going to take a bit of a lead here. Wuhan's actually missed a fair few times, so did Hakurei Rainbow. So actually, scores are really close right now. It's going to come down to this death stream here. It looks like all players are holding strong, but Taiwan pulling ahead. Due to Rocker, Smolka, and Snow White doing really, really good here. Kirikaru is broken for Korea. We only have Shizuru and Dungeon holding strong for Korea right now. So Taiwan actually being able to take the best out of this death stream with Snow White, Smolka, and Rocker still holding full combo. Rocker with amazing accuracy again.
Seeming like that, actually, we can say that Korea does have a weakness, and that is control. They're fast, really, really fast. When it comes to reading and these kind of beatmaps, you see the difference. I'm not surprised to see this result by Taiwan.
Yeah, and this is going to go towards Taiwan by 12 million points with 3 full combos by Rocker, Smolka, and Snow White. 18 million points for each. Rocker with amazing accuracy, 98.83%, only 11 100s with Hard Rock on overall difficulty A for Korea though. Shizuru once again and Dungeon get a full combo with 18 million points as well, but Kirikaru and Hakurei Rainbow are quite far behind in score, so that's going to give Taiwan this win, and they come back to 3-2. This is definitely a close match.
I wonder what, like, you can only pick one double time beatmap, that's right, isn't it? And that means that technically, Korea does not have the 3 points anymore, like, the advantages in that kind of sense. They need to focus on beatmaps that's really fast, something that they can really challenge Taiwan on. They know from before that what they're best at is what is, like, what you can say, like, just fast, generally fast reading. If you put anything complex into it, I feel Taiwan is the better team.
This is true, yeah. And if you look at the maps they can select, there's still Yakujin Summon of Couple Dance, Infinite of Nuclear Fusion, and Kamui Left for Nomad, the Hidden Pool, the Hard Rock Pool, and the Free Mod Pool.
I think Korea would be wise to choose a beatmap like Kamui at the moment. something that can really use emphasize their fast swimming abilities. I saw mm-hmm. Dragon Human playing Kamui, and he just pulled through those streams like they were nothing. And I'm pretty sure that other of these players like Chizuru, Dungeon, and also Haku Reimu, if he decides to stay, can really play through that kind of BPM. So on Korean side, I would really recommend him to do that. Just get Dragon Human back in and play Kamui.
Yeah, when it comes to high speed, high BPM and streams and whatnot, I think Korea pretty much has the advantage, mainly due to Chizuru Dungeon, like you said. But unfortunately for them, it isn't what makes the bulk of this this map pool this time. Because when it comes to fast beat maps, of course, you have Yakuji-sama and a couple dents at the end, but that's only towards the end, and Kamui. But other than that, Infinite Nuclear Fusion, I don't think is that fast.
No, it's the thing about BPM, nuclear fusion. So. Nuclear fusion has, I think, even though it's a very modern map, it still has the feel of 2011. Actually, almost a bit 2010 in it, and it's kind of the reason why I like it so much, because it's fusing the past and the present in sort of way that the patterns are well thought through, but it's also a little bit of a complexity to it in the drums as well. I feel that if you were to play Korea against Taiwan on that, I wouldn't be surprised to see Rocker and Snow were playing really well on that particular beatmap, while you would see some of the Korean players be struggling on it because they are not as consistent when it comes to accuracy. Especially when we have an OD10 beatmap, it can be really dreadful to play that sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, right now, when it comes to high BPM, the only options remaining for Korea are either, like I said, Yakuji-sama and a couple dance or Kamui, but also for free mod, they still have Sermon to pick from. It's 212 BPM, but other than that, Mephisto's 170. Scream Hard As You Can is 198, and Caramel Heaven's not that fast either, it's 194, so it's definitely BPMs that the Taiwanese team can handle.
As long as you get like past a certain BPM, this is why I think Kamui is the best choice. Because I believe that some of the Taiwanese players might actually struggle a little bit on that. Obviously, it's the kind of beatmaps you get from Double Time, 240, 250 BPM. That's yeah. Korea is dominant, but they can't use this card anymore. Like, not Mephisto.
Oh, this, Mephisto. All right, free mod pick.
A free mod pick, 170 BPM, I believe, and it's constant streaming, jumping, and reading.
Yeah, we've seen this map actually at the beginning of us World Cup, doing testing. If you guys were here for that. This map is nuts. It's this map by Illumitors, and it's a really, really, really hard beat map, ranked quite recently. Dungeon actually has has the number 16 on it, so it's a pretty good score. She's the number 29, Tengu's number 38, Dragon Human's 41, and Haku Raymond's 44. So
definitely,
three players,
definitely
pretty good score.
A stamina map, I would say.
Oh, yeah.
Like constant, consistent streaming and stamina, basically.
It's just a death stream map, yeah. For Taiwan, we have Small Caves number 49 with Nomad, as well as I Will Be Back number 14, the full combo with Nomad also. I don't think we're gonna see any mods on this, quite honestly. Maybe Rocker's gonna try the Hard Rock, but I really doubt it, because this is another. We've seen Reunion Hard Rock, this is Mephisto, and despite it being slower, it's another matter entirely.
Well, I don't feel anyone is gonna do, because you'd be crazy if you did that. It's pretty hidden. We actually did discuss a little bit on putting this beatmap in the hidden bracket. I think it would just be... no one would actually pick that. No one is that crazy. Yeah. So luckily, since it's in the free mod, we can see Mephisto being played. And, well, I wouldn't be surprised to see at least one Hard Rock. Obviously, like, some of these players might actually feel that it's easier to play than Hard Rock, considering the Pro Threat 10 skills that some of these players have.
Let's see how we do here. Are we gonna have any switches? Let's see here. Yes, Tengu's gonna replace Kirikaru on this, which really isn't surprising for Korea. Nope. roster changes for Taiwan so far?
Seems like only Shizuru and Dungeon that's like the regulars here.
Yeah, well, they've been doing exceptionally well this entire match, so it's really no surprising that they remain. It's pretty much like Snow White and Rucker, even though Rucker was not here the first map, but we do have a player switch from Taiwan. I will be back soon to play Small K. We have a lot of player switches. We should be able to start anytime soon.
Just before we start, see people asking if there's anyone using mouse. I don't think so, actually. I think most of these players are tablet, actually, all of them.
Like we said, Shizuru used to be mouse only, but he switched to tablet.
Well, on the bright side, whoever wins is going to be happy about the prize.
Well, yeah, that is true. I didn't even think about that. It looks like Taiwan's taking a bit of an early lead here. Rucker holding full combo, it's just Uwen and Snow White right now. For Korea, there's Dungeon doing really, really strong. But I think he's the only one actually holding combo for his team, so... Snow White has missed for Taiwan, but Rucker and Uwen still holding strong. If they can keep that up, they'll increase the lead, but it looks like Korea coming back here, because Snow White missed quite a bit, and Dungeon's still holding strong.
Well, we don't have any footage, let's just talk about Uwen. Because, well, it currently does seem to have the full combo. Do you have the streaming client, and are you able to
no,
see
it? No, unfortunately.
Alright.
If I had it, it would be frozen too, so...
Pretty much, yeah.
Not being quite sure we should have the results pretty quickly here.
And a sudden jump. It looks like Taiwan is doing pretty well. We can't see Tenga's result at the moment. I'm not sure if it's counting.
Yes, it is counting, but actually the results are in, and it's actually pretty clear win from Taiwan. We have a Rucker and Uwen actually full comp of the map. 20 million points from Rucker, 19 million points from Uwen, and the highest score for Korea is Hakurei Rim with 13 million points, so actually Taiwan has almost double the score of Korea on this, 29 million points of difference, so they're gonna catch up to Korea with effectively going back to 3-3, and it will also select the next map.
Beautiful performance by Uwen, he's managing to keep up the combo and he's helping his team a lot. Seems like Tengu is still trying to win for Korea.
Yeah, I think we had a bit of... It was a bit of a internet connection problem with Tengu. That's why the client lagged so much. Shouldn't happen anymore, hopefully, but...
And so Korea takes
that.
The lead.
Hooray. Hooray, the map was worth 2 points. No, not quite. That's still 3-3, don't worry people, we'll fix that really soon. But for our next map, it's going to go towards Taiwan now. Taiwan, they have used their Hard Rock pick, so they can't go for it again. They have to go for Nomad, Fremont, or Hidden, or Double Time if they want to lose. But yeah, it's going to be interesting because both teams actually have used their mod of preference.
Yes, actually. Did Taiwan choose a hard rock beatmap as far?
Yeah, they picked Reunion.
That was Reunion, and from the Korean side. Well, I'm pretty sure that Korea is going to be picking something that's fast as possible. Can we for certain
be? We have a hidden pick from Taiwan, Heaven's Race Guitar Style.
I am really surprised. I wonder if they've been practicing this a lot.
Now that's interesting. That's an approved map. It actually lasts for a while, actually 5 minutes in total. 180 BPM on the hidden. Let's see how players do on this. Really interesting pick right there from Taiwan.
I think Korea is going to be raging a lot about this. I'm trying to play a little bit myself, and I really understand their point of view. Like, you have to keep up your concentration. Playing difficult hidden map for like feels really slow, and has a lot of rapid jumps considering the BPM and all that. So really, just having to keep up that concentration for such a long time. I don't see Korea being the best team at this one. I think Taiwan is doing a really wise pick at the moment.
Cheese is going to replace Hakuei Reimu, and only 4U is going to replace I Will Be Back. But if you look at the top 50, actually, Cheese is number 5 with Hidden, and Dungeon's number 7 also with Hidden. So they definitely have their chance here. Although Uwen also has Full Combo with Hidden, is number 15, and only 4U is number 9 also with Hidden. So it could really go either way, as always, with this match.
Seems to me like the most important players on the Korean side for this one is Tango and Cheese. Obviously Dungeons as well. But I feel the fast players, the really double time players, is going to struggle with this. Because playing double time is detrimental to this kind of skill.
I would be honest with you, I really didn't think we'd see that kind of beatmap in the finals, but there it is, actually, Taiwan pulling it putting a bit of a curveball to Korea. Let's see how they do on this. I think we have an early break from Dungeon for Korea, so looks like there's going to be an early lead from Taiwan on this.
If Taiwan has been practicing this rightly, it gives them a crazy advantage, just considering, just look at these jumps. Pay attention to the overlaps. See how many things you just don't understand and see, because basically I'm struggling with this, especially on the default skin. It's really hard to see that the pace, when to click, how to do things right. Is there actually a note there? Is there not a note? Sometimes your eyes will see phantom notes when playing this card on beatmaps, because you're so aware, looking for those notes constantly. If you do not know about the notes, you might struggle more than you would imagine.
Oh yeah. As a rule, playing hidden on Black Hat Alliance maps is usually pretty painful, but right there, you can see Snow White and only 4U doing really well for their team. They're still holding Full Combo, and nobody is on the Korean side, so if they can keep that up, they'll get a huge, huge combo score boost. Actually, Snow White broke, but only 4U is still holding up. He can potentially carry Taiwan here.
This is the thing though, like, you can be playing as well as you like. This is a concentration map, and concentrating in the finals, like, are you serious? For 5 minutes and 1 second, is a bit much. I mean, that's just crazy.
Yeah, and also you have to not give in to the nerves, because in the final, it's the freaking finals. There's so much hype, so much it's just so much hype, and the stress is so ever so present for every player. But only 4U, it's still holding Full Combo, pretty much carrying the entire team of Taiwan right now.
This is genius. Only 4U is one of the best players I know when it comes to strange beatmap maps. He can play the most ridiculous you would never want to play, because it's just so, either it's boring or it's just plain ridiculous, easy mod, like really small circles or just these kind of beatmaps. Having a player like Only 4U here, who is such a gimmick player in terms of weird beatmaps and still is a really good player, this is genius.
It's really, really working out well. He has 16 million points. He's way, way, way ahead of any other player in that match. I mean, the closest that comes to him is Rucker's score right now, and he's not even at 10 million points.
You gotta really praise the tactics from the Taiwanese side.
Yeah, I don't think a Korea can actually come back from this, only for your stealth link combo. So, and Rucker is actually really, really strong score as well. So Taiwan's going to keep increasing the lead. They almost have 20 million points of difference right now. So it looks like it's going to be a fairly clear win from Taiwan. This was a huge gamble, but it worked out really well for Taiwan.
In the beginning, I really thought that if Taiwan doesn't win these heartbeat maps in the beginning, then Korea will just see this out. But it seems that the list is actually containing substantial maps that can actually give Taiwan that advantage because they can play the weird stuff. Korea has the major weakness that pretty much most of their players are the similar type of players.
Only four finally breaks, but Rucker now is taking his place with over 1,000 combo. Dungeon, though, for Korea is also holding strong. They're gonna try to come back here, but it's going to be difficult. You can also see Snow White almost at 1,000 combo. So, despite only Poryu's miss towards the end, the rest of the Taiwan team caught up and is ready to carry their team to victory. Look at the score difference. It's ever so increasing for Taiwan, and despite Dungeon's best efforts, it doesn't look like Korea is going to be able to come back. Shizu is also doing really nicely, but this is going to be a win from Taiwan. Genius play from Rucker, actually getting more points than only for you. Rucker getting no misses, only 4 100s, 99.76%. He actually takes the best score on this with 34 million points. Only for you, like we said, 32, and Snow White 27 million points. Taiwan pulls off a huge gamble and win this by 35 million points. Really, really impressive decision from the Taiwanese side.
The best decision of all is that if they swap an only for you on the next beat map, they still have their optimal team if they put in like Small K or something like that.
Mm-hmm. I'll be honest with you, I did not see that move come from Taiwan, that curveball.
I'm surprised too, but I'm happy. I'm happy that Taiwan has been doing substantial preparation. They've probably been discussing this a lot, and they've probably been they're following a clear tactic. So, huge praise to the Taiwanese team. They're doing this the right way. They're pulling out the weakness of Korea, and they're trying to use it to their advantage. They only need two more wins.
Yeah, this is true, and I mean, usually when we see curveballs like these, it's usually on free mod picks. There's usually one or two strong players that will try and put like hidden hard rock or sometimes hidden hard rock and try to full combo and carry their team. This time, they're actually selecting a specific mod that hinders all players, and as a result, only 4U and Rucker are able to carry. I think this is a really, really, really clever play from Taiwan, and a very well-deserved point in this match.
So let's see if we can see some Kamui, shall we?
You're really eager for that map, aren't you?
This is what I'm expecting to see, to be honest.
Our next pick is going to be selected by Korea. Now that Taiwan have made their amazing comeback from 2-0 to 4-3, they have to come back now. They have no choice, and Dragon Human's coming back to hopefully save the day for Korea. He's going to replace Cheese on this next map that they will select. and it's going to be Caramel Heaven. So that's a pre-mod pick, actually, from Korea. Let's see how that goes. Last pre-mod pick, Mephisto, didn't quite work out that well for them. Let's see how this one goes. Quite faster, this one. 192 BPM, or 94 BPM, sorry. 194 BPM.
It's kind of surprising you don't see any of the hard rock scores in this one. I don't expect any of the Korean players to play hard rock because of that. Though I see some hidden scores. I wonder if they're going to go through with that. Tengu has a hidden score with a pretty good accuracy.
Actually, Dungeon has a double S with a hidden on this. And like you said, Tengu.
But honestly, this is not what I expected. Like, I don't feel this is the best pick for Korea at the moment. I think if they lose the next pick and Taiwan is able to put in the killing blow, what I think is Jackie Jin or something like that, then
that would be
it's
really,
over.
That would be really, really... Right now, Korea has to select the right map, because if they don't, it's going to be 5-3 for Korea. Taiwan, 5-3 for Taiwan, and Taiwan's going to be one map short of winning the finals, and they will select that map, which gives them an early advantage. So they absolutely must not pick the wrong map, must not get countered by Taiwan here, because it is going to put them in an awful situation. And let's see if we're going to see any player swap outs for Taiwan. It doesn't look like it for now, but generally we see... I mean, I think there's been at least one player switch from each team for every map, so...
I think so too. I'm not surprised to see Only For You being swapped up. I was expecting him to only be a part of the Hidden Bait map, so... Yeah. And he's really played a great role in achieving that victory,
so...
Definitely.
He's had his time to shine, so to speak. I think we're gonna see Small K coming back here. I will be back. All right, that's another one I wasn't expecting, but I will be back. We've seen him a few times this match. The one player we haven't seen so far is Yuko Sama, though. I'm quite surprised. He's actually a pretty strong player, and we haven't seen him at all so far. We're both. Alright, there we go with our next map, our Caramel Heaven. Let's see if we get any mods on this.
Tengu's acting funny again.
Yeah, Tengu's probably having a quite slow internet again. Hopefully there's
fireworks.
Not disconnections.
You can see that the Ars logo is beating pretty heavily at the moment. It's probably the heart rate, how it feels like to have a full combo.
Pretty good comparison, yeah.
And now we only see Tengu, it's a nice swap.
Alright, of course. And no mod apparently from any of the players, which I can't say that I expected any mods, but I don't know, you never know at this stage. I mean, if Taiwan pulled the gamble that they pulled last round, I mean, you can pretty much expect anything right now.
Well, yeah, that's exactly the thing, though. I think it's up to Snow White and Rocket again, pretty much. If they can keep it up, then Korea has to get at least 3-4 combos. I think the chances of that happening is higher than on the Taiwanese side. However, I think that Snow White and Rocket are the best players here in this tournament, and they're the most likely to get the full combo.
See how things go. For now, no combo breaks at all to be mentioned. Actually, you look at the accuracies, they're really, really high right now. Several players holding double S.
So it seems the Koreans taking it slightly. Actually, they're playing really well at the moment. Three double S's.
Yeah, no combo breaks from them. I think I will be back missed for Taiwan. So
basically, maybe the beat map isn't hard enough. Like, maybe it sounds kind of ridiculous to say that, but the beat map isn't hard enough. So that the differences between the Snow White and Roku and the skill of the rest of the players isn't as significant anymore, and that gives Korea the slight advantage.
Any miss from the Korean side, though, is going to be lethal for them.
As we know, we can still see Taiwan coming back from this, because there are 3-4 combos on the Taiwanese side. Obviously, there's 3 versus 4 at the moment. If we do see a miss from one of the Korean players at this moment, the results will change quite rapidly at this point.
Yeah, this is the thing, is that I will be back missed, yes, but he missed quite early on. It was the first chorus. Now he's able to come back at 600 combo. They only need one miss from one of the Korean players to come back, but we've seen that Korea can go through an entire map without missing. We've seen that with a double time pick, so
you don't get the feel that they're gonna miss either. If there's gonna be a miss, it's gonna be so late. I don't think quite Taiwan can keep up. Well, worth mentioning that the only double S at the moment is Rocker, who is keeping it up really nicely at the moment. And there came the miss from Shizuru, and so the results will rapidly change towards the last seconds, but I think it's too late. There should only be like a couple of seconds left for the beat map. Actually, it's so incredibly close.
It's so close, but I think Korea's got this. It's going to come down to the wire. And we're gonna have, oh my god, this is ever so close. But this is gonna be a win for Korea by 7 million points. They do pull it off. Dongjin, Tengu, and Dragon Human all full comboing. And Shizu really close to the full combo, only one miss. Dragon Human almost so close to the SS. And actually, speaking of double S, Rocker gets it. 100% accuracy. Also, you have Snow White and one getting full combo, but too bad for Ali Back. He got no 100s, but only one miss, and that miss gives Korea the win. They come back to 4-4. Really, really strong play by both teams. I don't understand. Why didn't we see any mods? That probably would have changed the situation.
It could have, obviously. I think it's Taiwan using any of the mods. They could have taken the win by the score difference that they would have generated. But the thing is, just you don't know these stuff. You can't predict. Yeah. And obviously, this is a pretty hard beatmap to be stable on in the first place. But I did feel that Snow White and Rocker should have been using mods, considering how good they are. And considering how the harder beatmap is, the more they advantage they can pull out.
Yeah, this was a really, really nice play by Korea. They now come back to 4-4. And our next map is going to be selected by Taiwan.
Will we see Jackajin? That's the question.
I think the thing with Jackajin Samando couple dance is that players are too scared to pick it, because you can fail right towards the end and your score comes down to nothing. And that's really, really scaring the players.
I feel though that Taiwan is the least likely to fail at that part. They have Rocker and Snow White. They were playing a lot during that time as well, and I feel that really this is a chance they shouldn't just throw away. If it's not Yakujin, it's definitely a nuclear fusion or something of the like.
Well, right now, they can select two of the beatmaps from the free mod pool, or two of the beatmaps from the no mod pool, or they could choose double time, but that wouldn't really be wise. So, really, their options are quite restricted here.
Definitely. Taking a double time pick will be an innocent loss. Considering. But at least we can say that Taiwan at the moment is on the offensive. I feel the remaining maps are in slight favor to them.
Mm-hmm. They can still choose from Yakujin from a couple dens.
Needs to know that, well, I think that if it comes down to the tiebreaker, I still feel that Korea is the best team. Taiwan really needs to win this one.
Oh, that's interesting, yeah. It would be really cool, though, to see a tiebreaker on the finals. We've never had that happen. But yeah, the remaining maps that Taiwan can pick are Yakujin Summon a Couple Dance, Infinite of Nuclear Fusion, Kamui for Nomad, the Double Time Pool, which I don't think we're gonna see any of that, and two maps on the Free Mod Pool, Scream Hard As You Can, and Sermon.
I feel actually the Korea is the better team when it comes to these two free more picks. Really, Taiwan needs to focus on either Nuclear Fusion or Yakujin Summon a Couple Dance.
It's actually interesting because right now Taiwan is in the situation Korea was last map, because they're selecting the next map. If they pick the wrong one, Korea's gonna be one map short of winning, and they'll select the next one, so they'll get a really, really good advantage. So now Taiwan has all the stress in the world.
Nah, I feel it's Korea that's in the biggest trouble at the moment, to be honest. Considering just because Taiwan is the one picking the big map at the moment.
Probably, yeah.
And we just peaked above 10k views, which is pretty amazing.
Alright, I did say we were gonna break the 10k limit. We did, congratulations, and thank you all for watching, of course, as always.
Surprisingly though, there's not as many users connected. I saw him doing the last rounds, it was like 13k users connected, now it's doing like 12.6k.
Alright, Taiwan's still selecting the next map. There's a lot of stress involved, so we should be able to see what they select anytime soon. Let's see for any player swaps.
I think the next beatmap has to be announced before we see any pirate swap.
Mm-hmm.
And for those who have jumped in later, just to present yourself for the third time, I'm Akrius, and with me is Mr. Color.
Mr. Color, hi!
I have no idea why I almost said lol cubes.
Maybe you just really, really wish Lolcubes was here to commentate with you?
Yeah, I know. He has a day off. He should be commentating with us. I don't think he has a day off, actually. It was just me misinterpreting something.
All right. Ooh, our next up is going to be Freemod. Cement TV size. And wow. We get a Valor 1-away pick.
I did not expect that from Taiwan. I do consider Korea to be the better side of this beat map. Mostly because it's one key, it's fast. You can obviously get two keys on this, but it's really hard to control the patterns. And it's also in that kind of zone, the kind of alternative beat map that's in the hard zone. I think it's 240 BPM. And alternating 120 BPM streams is really, really difficult. And so it becomes really annoying, and you have to either be a really fast one keyer or a really solid alternate player. So it's the hardest kind of alternative beatmap, really.
Yeah, surprisingly, 212 BPM.
212?
Yeah.
Alright. Well, in that case, it's just one key for everything you got. Sorry about that.
And when it comes to the players, we have Smallcake gonna replace. I will be back for Taiwan. I don't think we have any changes yet for Korea. We might see some though.
But yeah, I think this is really too bad. I felt that Taiwan was the better team of the other big maps. So it's going to be interesting to see though. Obviously, if Taiwan has been playing this a lot and been practicing, they have a chance. But
yep. Whoever loses this is going to be an incredibly bad situation.
And nobody is using mods this time either. Everyone is taking this very seriously.
Yep. The stakes are way too high, I think.
I think the only reason we did see some of the players using Hard Rock in the past is because the stake wasn't as high and they knew they could pull off the win either way. Oh, there's some really, really ugly misses from Shizuru. He's really was confused by that pattern. Maybe I was wrong about this beatmap. Maybe it is more complex than I thought. And if it's too complex, we know that Taiwan is the better team, so.
Yeah. Right now, since it was an early miss and Uwan also had an early break, it is still anyone's game. I think we had a break from Smallcake also, so actually, Korea's gonna be able to take the lead on this, but like I said, it's still anyone's game. It's not decided yet.
I think as long as Snow White and Rock can pull off the full combos, it might actually be enough. We don't know for sure what Dragon Human and Dungeons are capable of. I do expect Dungeon to keep it up, but Dragon Human can still miss this, so we'll see. And obviously Tengu as well. He's doing really
well. A miss from Snow White, actually. That's really, really bad for Taiwan.
Yeah, that's a game over. How really strange that they didn't choose to play a different beatmap than this.
Well, right now the score difference is actually quite... but the map's already over. I forgot how short that map was.
Yeah, it's really short.
That's a win for Korea by 2 million points. Yeah, I forgot how short these beatmaps are, but yeah. Full combo by Dungeon and Tengu. Really, really nice play. Look at these accuracies. They're really, really high. For Taiwan, we do have Rocker and only Rocker getting a full combo, doing really well also for himself, but that's not going to be enough. He's against two full combos / three with Dragon Human.
Let's just see if Taiwan can pull it off in the next one. I believe they both use up their free mod, their Heart Rock and Double Time pick, which means the next pick is going to be no mod for sure.
Korea's going to select the next map, so it's either going to be Yakujin Summon a Couple Dance, Infinite of Nuclear Fusion, Kamui, one map from the Hidden Pool, one map from the Hard Rock Pool, or Scream Hard as You Can from the Freemod Pool. And it's going to be Hard Rock, actually. They're selecting Lag Fox Forever.
Oh, yeah, that kind of makes sense, actually, because it's fast. Basically, fast.
Alright, so Uwan's gonna... is going to switch and replace Uwan, and Hakuri Rainbow is going to replace Tengu for this. It's going to be really weird. I did not expect a Hard Rock pick from Korea. This is really risky, though. We've seen how good Taiwan is with Hard Rock. Once again, this is a gamble.
The thing is, just this beatmap is fast. It takes away the advantage that Taiwan has over Korea. I think they're going to win this one. And approaching what could be the last speed map we're going to see today, is we have actually gone as far up as 11.3k. Almost 11.4k.
That's because of how close this match is. Imagine if Taiwan wins this, we're actually going to get a tiebreaker on the finals.
This channel is the fourth highest view count in the entire Twitch at the moment.
Yep, we're good, guys. We're really good.
Taiwan is actually off to the best start at the moment because of early break from Shizu. Now the interesting thing I think about this beatmap is it's not really up to aim. In fact, of all the beatmaps that are similar to Reunion, this is the one that's most similar. Considering that aiming is not the hard bit, because it's not very jumpy. As you can see, the notes are pretty much connected all over. It's all about being able to keep up the pace and string it properly. And I feel that, honestly, it takes away a bit of the advantage that Korea has over Taiwan when it comes to pure aiming and jumping ability. You don't need that kind of ability when you're playing these kind of beatmaps.
Yeah, but this is still really close right now. Not any players are missing, so it's really going to come out to whoever misses the first is going to track their entire team down. Right now, Taiwan has a very, very slight advantage of only 1 million points, but then again, this could all crumble to dust in an instant.
Also remember that if Taiwan actually managed to pull this one off, we will see a tiebreaker as in the final beatmap. And beyond that, it's really hard to say. Like, sometimes it just feels like Korean's gonna win and then they don't. Or it feels like Taiwan's gonna win and they don't. It's just really hard to say sometimes.
It's so close right now.
It's not just up to ability. Like, you can put
there's
pretty
a miss
much
by Hakurei Reimu, though, for a Korean side. That's really, really bad. Taiwan hasn't missed yet. They have the opportunity to pull off here.
That's a really, really unfortunate miss from the Korean side.
You can see they're starting to take off and score. We're gonna be close to 10 million points of difference really soon. But we have a miss from Snow White for Taiwan, so that actually evens the odds because Hakurei Reimu actually missed again, pretty much at the same spot. So it sets everyone straight. But here's the miss from Small K coming in, so Korea actually can come back right now.
Right now, if it keeps on going like this, Korea's gonna take the win.
The score difference isn't that big right now, so there's definitely room for upsets here.
Unless the last part of the beatmap is really slow, because then you don't get as much points as fast.
Evidently.
But as you can see, Korea is really, really, really catching up with Taiwan at the moment.
Yeah, they're
passing
the lead
them
here. Oh, but Dragon Cuban misses for Korea right at the end, so it's actually really close.
It's back. They're both gaining points as equally fast, and Taiwan is keeping like one of 2 million points ahead.
Yeah, they have an ever so small advantage. This is gonna come down to the wire. It's so close, and this is gonna be a win for Taiwan by less than a million points. 883,000 points. Taiwan take this. We're going into tiebreaker with 38 million points by Rocker.
This is brilliant.
Ooh, that was so close, but this is a win for Taiwan by practically nothing.
I I'm really happy to see this. Like, we actually got to the tiebreaker. I wonder if it's a kind of like a psychological thing, like
Ooh.
the players kind of concede to getting to the tiebreaker. I mean, the chances for that is really small considering when it's best of 11, but still, it's just really amazing.
Oh my god. All right, a full combo from Rocker and a full combo from Dungeon from each team. Davin Long also did really well for Taiwan with 34 million points. So did Shizu for Korea, sorry, with 33 million points. But overall, by practically nothing, Taiwan pulls it off and is able to drag Korea into the tiebreaker. Distorted Love Song is going to be our tiebreaker, and be ready for 7 minutes of absolute madness.
So for those interested in knowing that the current tiebreaker was mapped by RLC, and I think it's one of his best works in terms of the way it's built up. It's almost like it was created to become a tiebreaker. The reason why I'm saying this is because it starts off being quite difficult, but it exponentially, not quite exponentially, but it slowly becomes harder and harder. Some of the patterns are becoming harder and more difficult to read. And so as it progresses, the more points you will get, the more likely a team will lose or break a combo, which means breaking a combo in the hard parts here is really dangerous in terms of you may not be able to build another combo again.
All right, a few figures about this map though. On the top 40, two full combos. One by Sapphire Ghost, one by Ryuichi. Actually, he pulled the double S on it. But only two full combos. That is it.
This is probably one of the hardest to get a full combo bitmap that was ranked or approved this year.
Yeah. Dungeon is number 3. Snow White is number 5. Shizu's number 6. Fury is number 8. Hakuri Rim is number 19. Dragon Human is number 22. Coming into this tiebreaker, I feel that Korea has that advantage. It's 240 BPM. It's really freaking goddamn fast. So Korea does have the advantage on the paper, but Taiwan, we've seen them. They've pulled so many trump cards this entire match. They've been able to come back so much, and now it's a tiebreaker. It's when whoever wins this is winning the US World Cup 2013. So the stakes are so big. There's going to be so much stress involved. I feel both teams have an equal chance.
Yeah, it's really no way to say. We could obviously we can argue about Taiwan might have an opportunity to actually do something really well because they have Snow White, have Rocker, players that have really good aim and do perform at a really high level. However, we know that the Korean side has four players that are equal opportunity to get a full combo of this potentially, and which is why it's so dangerous to see what's going to happen. I also think that if we see at least one, I think the team with the full combo, if there's going to be one, is going to win. Basically, this is where the great players decide.
Yep. So we have our standard setup for Taiwan, as usual, one small K, Rocker, and Snow White. And for Korea, we have Fury. We haven't seen that much during this entire match. Dragon Human, Dungeon, and Shizu. Let's see how they do. And we have our first miss of the match from Uen for Taiwan, and I think Rucker also combo broke, also from Taiwan. So we have a pretty early lead from Korea on this.
Obviously, nothing is decided yet. Interesting to see that Chizuru hasn't skipped his bitmap yet. He can still skip if he wants to. Just press the space button. Come on, do it.
Here we go, we're back, sorry about that. Actually, I have a few breaks around the board. We see Shizuru and Dungeon actually combo broke for Korea. So, Taiwan actually has a chance to come back. Small K hasn't missed yet, but Korea is still has Fury and Dragon Human with a full combo.
Pretty much getting to the part where building a combo is extremely important.
Oh, wait, no, actually, Shizuru and Dungeon didn't miss at all. It was just playing lag, so... The entire, well, there goes Fury, but before that, the entire team of Korea was getting full combo, so... They have a comfortable lead right now, but it's still not decided yet, because the song is so long.
In terms of what kind of beatbump this is, it's just in the advantage of Korea at the moment. It's a kind of no-more pick. The Koreans play a lot because they're so fast, and so they need these kind of songs to enjoy it.
It's gonna be hard comeback here from for Taiwan, but it's still doable. However, for Korea, Dungeon and Dragon Human are still doing God's work here. If you look at their accuracies, it's actually really, really incredible how they're doing.
One thing that's really nice about this beatmap is though, if you're good enough to play it, it's still so fast. You are so busy focusing on the notes, you don't really have time to think about, oh shit, if I miss, or something like that.
Yeah.
When
you
a beatmap becomes this...
Die.
Yes, if this, when a beatmap is this intense, then if you're already playing, then you won't really be distracted by anything else, because you know as long as you're distracted, you won't be able to even follow the notes. Some crazy play from Dragon Human at the moment.
Oh, and there's a miss from Rocker. That's gonna hurt them because right now they have no high full combos, and Dragon Human and Dungeon still getting full combos. So Korea is looking really good right now. They're well on their way to a third Host World Cup win in a row. Because the miss from Dungeon, but Dragon Human is still holding strong for Korea, and they have over twice Taiwan's score right now.
We also pretty much passed the hardest bit of this beatmap.
Yeah, we see actually breaks all around the board, except for Shizuru. He's actually coming back quite nicely for Korea, increasing the lead even more. Snow White's also doing really well for Taiwan, which is a bit behind in comparison to Shizuru.
Mostly getting to the point of no return.
I think, yeah.
You say that the scores are increasing, but... Korea isn't surprisingly enough maintaining that, having double the score.
It's like every time there's a player from Korea that misses, someone else takes a relay with an absurdly high combo. Like right now it's Shizuru. There he goes actually. And Snow White's actually following quite nicely. I don't think that's going to be enough for him to come back, especially when you have Dungeon starting to catch up like this. But it is definitely really, really good for Taiwan right now.
Yeah, obviously they're getting points much faster than Korea at the moment, but when you consider the lead that they have.
The problem is Snow White is on his own here, and he's against four Korean players because the rest of the Taiwanese team seems to have trouble. And there goes the miss for Snow White too. The Taiwanese team really has trouble with this map. We've seen that, and we're coming into the end here. Taiwan will not be able to close the gap. There's no way. It's going to be Korea's game, third OS World Cup in a row.
Seems like Shizuru is having a fit.
Well, I think I would be too in his situation.
Probably so pumped up for this match in particular. And so it's decided. We see Korea is actually winning.
The champions take their throne once again. 60 million points of difference with an incredible score from Dragon Human with only one miss. He takes 50 million points. Dungeon takes 48 million points. That alone is enough to be Taiwan on this. Congratulations to Korea once again. Third year in a row they win the OS World Cup. Against a Taiwanese team that really threw it all in this match. But in the end, it does not matter because it's 240 BPM. It's Korea's pretty much playground here. And they do take this OS World Cup 2013 third win in a row. Congratulations to them. Even with their new roster, they managed to get it. That is just incredible.
Really well done by Korea. Obviously, there's many of us hoping that Taiwan is going to put up a fight, and they definitely did. I think Taiwan was doing really well tactically and skillfully to keep up with Korea, taking back the lead at one point, and then losing it, which was unfortunate.
It was undoubtedly our best finals we've ever had in OS World Cup history here.
Definitely the closest.
Yeah, by far. Even though the tiebreaker was one-sided, which I kind of was expecting, but oh well. It was a really close match, and I wanna congratulate both teams because they've been doing extremely well. Before this match, Taiwan had only lost two maps out of the entire tournament. But in the end, it's Korea's game because they just I don't know what Korean did that was different from, but they did so much better than the rest of the tournament somehow. Like, As we were saying, they were conceding maps to a lot of teams. They conceded maps to Chile, to France, to Austria, and so on. And I was thinking, well, perhaps Korea's not as strong this year. Perhaps it's another team's time to shine. But apparently, Korea still stands strong, even without their star players from previous years. Once again, they take the win, third year in a row. And it's just incredible. But anyway, that is it for our grand finals. But make sure to check out our third place match later today at 7 PM UTC. We have United Kingdom versus Poland. European match for third place. It's going to be very interesting. I will be there to commentate it. Hoping to see you guys there as well. But once again, congratulations to Korea. Good game to Taiwan. This was really, really close. It came down to the tiebreaker, to the wire. And
Let me just correct you on that. It's on Sunday, 7 PM UTC.
Oh, it's on Sunday, okay. That's tomorrow, actually, because I can't read, apparently. So yeah, it's tomorrow. Tomorrow at 7 PM UTC. So make sure you guys tune in for that. As always, thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for breaking the 13,000 viewer limit. This is really, really, really intense. But see you guys tomorrow at 7 PM UTC for the third place match. I'll be there and see you guys then.
Goodbye, everyone.